If you're watching this video, you're well aware that you should be fully defining all of your sketches in Fusion 360. Fully defining your sketch is a critical step in making parametric models. Use this one hidden trick when you're struggling to get that red lock icon in the browser. Remember, the red lock icon lets us know a sketch is 100% fully defined. Of course, the line color is the other thing to keep an eye on. Black lines represent fully defined objects, while blue line geometry and white endpoints are not yet fully defined. However, the line color is not always the best indicator. As you can see in this example sketch, everything appears to be fully defined. Most don't realize there is a hidden way to have Fusion 360 tell you exactly how many sketch entities are not yet fully defined. It will also highlight them for you, making it super easy to find them. Head to the View drop-down list and select Show Text Commands. You can also use Option Command C on Mac or Control Alt C on Windows. This shortcut opens the Text Commands pane at the bottom. It's here that we can run different commands similar to a command line, many of which are behind-the-scenes actions. For those familiar with AutoCAD, it's important to note that this is not a full-on command line compared to what's available in AutoCAD. Double-check that your text option is selected in the lower right corner. We can then type out sketch.ShowUnderconstrained. You can copy and paste this from the video description. Hit the Enter key to run the command. Notice running this command highlighted the two endpoints that are not constrained. The text command pane also calls out how many points are under constrained, as well as how many under constrained curves. In my file, you can see that I have an extra line placed here. This line is preventing the sketch from being fully defined and why the red lock icon doesn't appear. Using this little trick can help you find those pesky, unconstrained curves, particularly when their endpoints are overlapping other pieces of geometry that you may not spot otherwise. Lastly, it's important to note that these text commands are really only intended for internal use. Some of them can be dangerous and really mess up your Fusion 360. So please use this with caution and don't go entering a bunch of commands unless you're certain with the outcome. Over the years, I've written down a long list of Fusion 360 pro tricks, many of which are hard to discover on your own. Let me know in the comments below if you find quick videos like these to be helpful. If you enjoyed this tip, you can help me out by sharing this video with your fellow Fusion 360 users.